Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Manisha, junior resident in the Department of Radio Diagnosis from PGMS Rohtak. I'm presenting an unusual case of carcinoma rectum. Rectal cancer constitutes 42% of the total colorectal cancer. Patients with rectal cancer commonly present with change in bowel habits, bleeding per rectum, occult bleed, rectal mass, abdominal pain, and iron deficiency anemia. Due to distinctive anatomy and physiological features, there is increased risk of recurrence and local spread of rectal cancer. Prognostic determinants of rectal cancer are depth of invasion, number of lymph nodes involved, and circumferential resection margin involvement. Preoperative imaging plays an important role in helping deciding the management of rectal cancer and the most appropriate surgical technique. Imaging in rectal cancer is aimed at determining the stage of disease at diagnosis and thus deciding the appropriate management of the patient. Endoscopic USG. Endoscopic USG can differentiate the layers of the bowel wall and thus determining the depth of tumor invasion in early stages. EUSG can also be used to take FNA and biopsy in patients with early T-stage diseases. However, in post-urothelial patients, due to changes like inflammation, necrosis, and fibrotic changes, accuracy of endoscopic USG decreases. CT colonography. Abdominal CT can demonstrate regional extension of tumor as well as adenopathy and distant metastasis and thus is valuable in planning surgery for rectal cancer. Complications of rectal malignancy such as obstruction, perforation, and fistula can also be visualized with CT scan. Use of CT is critical for identifying metastasis, recurrences, evaluation, anatomic relationships, documenting normal postoperative anatomy, and confirming the absence of new lesions during and after therapy. The main disadvantage of CT are radiation exposure and difficulty in interpretation of pathology in presence of residual fecal matter, fluid, undistended or contracted segments of and or regional artifacts. Now we are discussing the case. A 59-year-old female patient presented to gynae OPD, complaining of high discharge per vaginum and pruritus. On clinical examination, the patient's cervix was bulky, edematous, and there was a foul-smelling discharge coming out of vagina. Ultrasound findings, minimal fluid collection with homogeneous echoes was noted in endometrial cavity. Cervix was bulky with fluid collection also in cervical canal. There was focal loss of fat plane of cervix with rectum, and there was evidence of also rectal wall thickening. CECT findings, axial sections of contrast enhanced CECT of pelvis showing heterogeneous enhancing thickening of both rectum and cervix with the suspicious loss of fat planes between cervix and rectum. In sagittal sections, distal rectum and anal canal appear bulky and heterogeneous. With circumferential wall thickening approximately 11 mm noted, the suspicious loss of fat planes with upper vagina. Cervix appears bulky with mild differential enhancement and fluid collection in cervical canal and also in the endometrial cavity, fluid is noted. On MRI, T2-weighted images show circumferential thickening of rectal wall with involvement of posterior wall of cervix anteriorly. However, the lumen of the rectum appears patent. Few of lymph nodes with irregular margins and heterogeneous signal intensity are noted in mesorectal fat on right side. On sagittal section, T2 hyperintense irregular circumferential wall thickening noted approximately 2 cm from anal verge for a length of approximately 5.6 cm. With loss of fat plane with the cervix and upper vagina anteriorly. Few round lymph nodes with the heterogeneous signal intensity and irregular margins are noted in mesorectal fat, which are suspicious. So the local stage of CA rectum came out to be as T4N1. In this case, 59-year-old female patient presented with the complaints of foul-smelling vaginal discharge and vaginal pruritus. On examination and ultrasound, the cervix and vagina were bulky and edematous with foul-smelling discharge per vagina. On the basis of clinical history and examination, the case was thought to be of a cervical malignancy. However, cervical biopsy for malignancy came out negative. CECT MR findings revealed the findings suggestive of some malignant rectal pathology with involvement of adjacent cervix and vagina. On rectal histopathological examination, moderately differentiated adenocarcinoma was found. Colorectal cancer is incredibly common, representing the fourth leading cause of cancer mortality and the second most common malignancy worldwide. Of all colorectal cancer, rectal cancer comprises over one third of cases, with over 40% arising within 6 cm of anal verge. For primary tumor staging, performing rectal MRI is important for evaluation of tumor location and morphology, T category, anal sphincter complex involvement, CRM status, involvement of pelvic sidewall, EMY, and N category. It is crucial to describe the tumor location in cranio-caudal length, circumferential plane, as well as length, relationship to anterior peritoneal reflection, and distance from inferior part of the tumor to anal verge. The information helps to determine the best surgical approach. Tumor located over 50 cm from anal verge are treated as colon cancer with their different staging and treatment protocols. Local staging has become very critical in patients' management due to increasing incorporation of neoadjuvant chemotherapy, which is basically required for locally advanced CA rectum to downgrade the tumor stage and thus followed by surgery. In our case, the staging on MRI came out as T4N1M0, which constitutes high-risk group. The recommended management protocol for this group is long-term chemoradiotherapy followed by surgery if possible. Usually, rectal malignancies present with bleeding per rectum, bowel obstruction, perforation, rectal mass. In complicated cases, patient may present with abscess formation, superficial collection, adjacent organ inflammatory changes, like in our case, like cervicitis, vaginitis. In such cases, patient history and clinical examination and imaging finding may sometimes mislead the diagnosis, and thus, in such cases, we need to do appropriate imaging modality, use appropriate imaging modality, and histopathological examination is very crucial to reach the accurate diagnosis. Thank you, everyone.